Hello, and welcome to Let's Read the Books of the Gagharv Trilogy. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Today I'll be reading Swordmaster, Volume 8, In a Tight Corner, or War Chronicles, Swordsmaster Zamza, Volume 8, In a Tight Corner, which was given to us by Neil right here in Dorks before sailing back to Beloa. War Chronicles, Swordsmaster Zamza, Volume 8, In a Tight Corner. Tempest started talking proudly. I have been researching ways to acquire more power the last 50 years. And I have found that in order to get more powerful magic, the only way is to revive ancient magic. For that, I needed a ritual that is grand in scale. I needed to find a way to give more blood to the earth. War is the best way to do that. It's a shame to let such an opportunity just pass. I'm going to ask that the Red Tribe collide with Milligan's army to give more blood to the Earth. Once I complete the ritual, I can take over the world. After he finished, Tempest nodded to himself in satisfaction. Zamza was calm under normal situations, but he was unable to keep his calm. His passion for his home and tribesmen was unmatched by anyone else. In fact, it would be wrong of him to remain calm after hearing what Tempest had just said. Zamza threw three daggers from the back of his hand, and at the same time, he advanced towards Tempest and flashed his sword. That instant, Tempest's body shined a bright light. When Zamza regained his sight, Tempest was nowhere to be seen. Ha ha ha. I have no intention of fighting with the Swordsmaster head on. I think I will have to excuse myself. Only his voice sounded in the tent. Oh, I almost forgot. It's useless for you to go and surrender yourself to Milligan. The Red Tribe, who is under my control, won't. Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of the Gagharv Trilogy, Swordmaster Volume 8, In a Tight Corner, or War Chronicles, Swordsmaster Zamza, Volume 8, In a Tight Corner.